Hello students, in the last lecture we studied AC circuit containing only resistance. So for AC circuit containing resistance only, we found that the AC supply was V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and the instantaneous current was also equal to Im sin omega t, where Vm and Im are the respective amplitudes of the voltage and the current. Both were the function of sine, that is, as the voltage increases, the current also increases in the same phase. As voltage decreases, the current will also become, it also decreases. That is, we call the phase difference between them is zero. However, if we try to find out the average of this voltage or current, it comes out to be zero. That's what we concluded in the end, that the average of AC current or AC voltage for one complete cycle, is zero, and that is quite obvious from the graph. So this was the voltage graph and this was the current graph. Both were the function of sine. So for one complete cycle, this was equal to zero in the terms of angle, this is pi, in the terms of time it was t by 2 and this is tan t. So for one complete cycle, the average of the AC voltage or AC current comes out to be zero. Now let us find out the RMS value of the current and the voltage. So RMS value of AC current and AC voltage. So anything or any physical quantity which changes continuously with respect to time, the magnitude as well as the direction keeps on changing continuously with respect to time, we find out the RMS value. Now the full form of this RMS is root mean square. This is root mean square, and the RMS value of any physical quantity is found only when that value changes continuously with respect to time. So here our AC current and AC voltage changes continuously with respect to time. So we go for a RMS value because the average comes out to be zero. So as the name indicate, let us define the RMS value of any physical quantity. Here we are going to find out the RMS value of AC current and AC voltage. So what is the root mean square value of any physical quantity? So this is defined as the square root of the mean of the square of any physical quantity. That is, we write the square root, or only root also, the square root of mean. So the square root of the mean of square of any physical quantity is called its RMS value, is called as RMS value. So the square root of the mean of the square of any physical quantity, the square root of the mean of square of any physical quantity is called its RMS value. So that is defined as root mean square. Now while doing the calculation, the steps are opposite. So suppose I want to find out the RMS value of AC current. So first I will square that quantity, then I will find out its mean, and then I will take its root. So while finding the RMS value, we have to do the reverse process in the sense First, we square the quantity, then we take a mean of that quantity, and then we do the square root of that physical quantity. And while reading or writing, we call it the square root of the mean of the square of any physical quantity. That is called as its RMS value. So let us find out the RMS value of AC current. Because at t is equal to 0, the I is 0, and at t is equal to capital T, so you can find out by yourself, omega can be written as 2 pi upon capital T multiplied by capital T cancel, so sine of 360 again comes out to be 0. So we find out this RMS value. So how to find out the RMS value? So let us find out the RMS value of current. So first thing is, we square this physical quantity. So we are doing an example for AC circuit containing only resistance. So first, I is equal to In sine of omega t, that is the instantaneous current. So this value is called as instantaneous current. The first step is you make a square of that quantity. So squaring both sides, it becomes Im square sine square omega t. That is, first we did the square. Then we take a mean. So we put a symbol for a mean like this. So Im square sine square omega t. So either you do this symbol or you put a bar on it, that is I bar square also. So these are the two symbols for average. Now how to find out the average of this sine and cosine function for one complete cycle? So we have a formula to find the average, of any function f of t, means it is a function of time. So the average of this function is equal to 1 by t 0 to t f of t dt. You do the integration of that function with respect to time and divide it by the entire time. So for one complete cycle, what will be its RMS value? So now we did the square of this quantity. Now we have to find out the mean. This is the symbol for a mean. Now this can be written as I square, the mean of I square is equal to, now Im is a maximum value and it is constant. Im is the maximum value and it is constant term. Because we know Im was nothing, but it was Vm upon capital R. That was it always a Ohm's law. So the constant value mean is same only. So it is Im square. We take the mean of sine square omega t because it is a function of time. Im is independent of a time. So now how to find out this? So if we see this formula, so in exam we will not be showing the calculation by doing the integration, but we will now try to remember that how to find out the mean of this physical quantity, and directly we will write here. So here you have to find out the mean of sine square omega t, that is equal to, so because the bio students will also be there. So here we will directly write the mean of this. When I do the mean of this sine square, it comes out to be half. So in exam, within bracket, we will write the mean of sine square omega t is half. Directly we should learn it. So this will be the mean of this function. This is the mean of this function. That is mean and square we did. Now we will do the root of this value. Now let us see how to find out. So I have to find out the mean of this. So I will write this as this formula, 1 by t integration 0 to t sine square omega t dt. this can be written as 1 by t integration 0 to t 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2 into dt. So this is the formula for bio student. You have to learn sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos of 2 theta divided by 2. Now this can be written as 1 by t, we open the bracket, 0 to t half dt minus integration 0 to t cos of 2 omega t divided by 2 into dt. This is equal to 1 by t integration of dt, that is small t, then we have a limit 0 to capital T, so it comes out to be t by 2 minus half, then we have a integration of cos, that will be equal to sin 2 omega t divided by, so here we do the derivative of this bracket, it comes out to be 2 omega limit 0 to t. So the half is taken out, then the integration of the cos is sin, so sin 2 omega t, then we do the derivative of this function 2 omega t with respect to time, the derivative is 2 omega, we divide it by 2 omega and the limit becomes 0 to t. So this is equal to 1 by t, t by 2 minus half, then this 2 is taken outside, so I can write 4 omega, then we put a limit sin of 2 omega in the place of this small t, I put a capital T minus sin of 0 and then again this bracket. So this is the method, but we will direct write this value. So this is the proof, 1 by t, t by 2 minus 1 upon 4 omega within bracket. Now this omega can be written as 2 pi by capital T. 2 pi by capital T. Omega is equal to 2 pi by capital T. So TT is cancelled. So we are left with 2 pi. 2 pi, 2 pi. That becomes sine of 4 pi minus sine of 0. Now sine of 4 pi and the sine of 0 both are 0. So this entire value becomes 0, so you are left with 1 by t into t by 2, so it becomes half. So this is the proof where the average of the sine square comes out to be half, that is the value is half. So this is the average of sine square, that is equal to half. So directly we write this half value here. Now I have to find out the RMS value. So the symbol can be, in the chapter we will follow a symbol capital I, so we can relate it with the DC current. So whatever DC formula were there, same formula will be there in the AC chapter, but you have to remember in this chapter capital A means RMS value. Capital I means RMS value of current. If I use capital V, that is the VRMS value of AC voltage. So small v, instantaneous voltage, capital V, RMS value of AC voltage, small I, instantaneous current, capital I, RMS value of AC current. So the formula for IRMS, which we will be using as a symbol capital I, or sometime we write IRMS like this. So, sorry, if I write a symbol small I, then I can also write small IRMS. So the formula now becomes square root, that is the square root, of mean of square. So square root of mean of square. Now see this formula, root mean square, root mean square. So either you write capital I or small I RMS, or sometimes we can also write this capital I RMS. So it is up to us. But in this chapter, in the coming lectures, we will use this symbol. You have to keep in mind that it is an RMS value. So now capital I is equal to square root of this. This is the mean and square. We take a root. So it becomes Im divided by root 2. So what is the RMS value? Say it does not comes out to be 0. It does not comes out to be 0. While the average of sine omega t, I found this average of sine square. Similarly, you can find out the average of the sine function here. Immediately the average will come out to be 0. So the average of sine or cosine, it comes out to be 0, and the average of sine square or cos square comes out to be half. Directly we will write whether you will get sine square or cos square, the value will be half. So this IRMS is equal to Im by root 2. Similarly, VRMS means capital V, or I can write VRMS is equal to Vm divided by root 2. So same process, first we square this quantity, then find its mean, and then do the root of that value. You will get Vm, that is a maximum value, divided by root 2. So this is the capital V, is a symbol for VRMS, that is the maximum divided by root 2. So if you do this maximum value, so in the graph we know that this is our Vm, this was our Vm. So let us draw this graph here. We draw an enlarged graph. This was your, if I say this is V graph, this was Vm. Vm divided by root 2, that is Vm divided by 1.414, then it comes out to be 0.707 times Vm. So if you divide this quantity by root 2, you will get 0.707. So that value will be somewhere here. So this value is Vm divided by root 2. Similarly, for AC circuit containing only resistance, this was the graph of the current. If this is Im, then this value, again we divide it by root 2. That is, if I multiply it by 100 on both sides, it becomes 70%. So IRMS value is the 70% of the maximum value. 70% of the maximum value. So this is how we find out the RMS, and the role is the same as DC current have. The DC current play a role in a circuit. So if you have an AC circuit containing resistor, inductor or capacitor, we generally deal with RMS value. For example, the supply at home, so at our home, the supply of AC voltage, the supply at home is 220 volt. Now what is this 220 volt? It cannot be V, it cannot be small V, it cannot be instantaneous value, because instantaneous value keeps on changing. See the sine graph. It cannot be average. So what is this V? So actually this V is 220 volt, that is capital V, or I can write it is VRMS. So what is the maximum voltage at our home? So if I have to find out the maximum voltage, I can write Vm is equal to root 2 times VRMS. So whatever supply we get at a home, it is the VRMS value. So later on I will be using the symbol capital V for VRMS. So capital V and VRMS symbol are the same. So root 2 times multiply by 220. If you do this calculation, the maximum supply at our home is about 311 volt. So you multiply 220 by root 2, that is 1.414, then the maximum value of AC supply at our home comes out to be 311 volt. Now let us see the power dissipated in AC circuit containing only a resistor. So now we found for AC circuit, containing resistor, what was the instantaneous voltage? So instantaneous voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and the instantaneous current I is equal to Im sin of omega t. That is equation number 2. So both the current and the voltage are in the same phase. Now we have to find out the instantaneous power dissipated in the circuit. So instantaneous power dissipated in circuit or in resistor. So there will be a loss of power. So instantaneous power dissipated in the resistor. All instantaneous value are denoted by small p. So small p is equal to V into small I. That is the formula for a power. So we substitute this value. So it becomes Vm Im sin square omega t. So this is the first thing. This is the instantaneous power. Now we find out the average power dissipated in the circuit. So average power dissipated is, so symbol of average, that is you put a bracket like this or put a bar on the symbol small p. So small p bar is equal to average Vm Im sin square omega t. Again Vm and Im are the constant, so they are, the average comes out to be same value. So Im Vm, so you have to take the average of only sin square omega t for one complete cycle. Now we will not show the calculation. We did this calculation. So now we directly write the average is half. So this is written within the bracket, that average of sin square omega t for one complete cycle is half. So this is the average power dissipated in the AC circuit containing only the resistor. Now we can also use the Ohm's law here to find out the current dissipated. Now we know that Vm is equal to Im upon R, that is Im into R, that is the Ohm's law. So in the place of Vm, we write the average power is equal to half Im square into R. So this is the average power dissipated in an AC circuit containing only the resistor. Now in order that we write this average power in the same form as a DC power, we use the RMS value. So to express AC power in the form of DC power, now we know what was the DC power in chapter 3, the capital P was equal to I square R. So whatever role that capital I played in chapter 3, in this chapter we will have the RMS value. So this capital I, the value of IRMS or the symbol for IRMS is capital I in this chapter, because we can relate it with the DC chapter. So capital I in this chapter will become IRMS actually. Now we know that IRMS or simply capital I is equal to Im divided by root 2. So here we have Im square. So Im square is equal to 2 times 2i. So I substitute here. So average power, which will be now replaced by capital P, it becomes I square R. So I substitute this Im square in the place of Im square. I will write 2 times I square, 2 is cancelled. So you have to remember the same formula as we did in the DC chapter, but the only difference is in the DC chapter the symbol capital I or capital V were the DC current and DC voltage, which remain constant with respect to time. Their magnitude as well as direction remain constant throughout the circuit or with respect to time. In this chapter, the current as well as voltage will continuously change with respect to time, and therefore the capital I actually it means IRMS value. It means IRMS value. So here to connect the AC and DC chapter, we replace this formula with the IRMS value, and when we replace it, the form of the formula, see, this is for DC, this is for AC, so it resemble, but what is the main difference here? Capital I is not DC current, it is actually Im divided by root 2, and we have a square, so again we come here, so this is actually IRMS value. So this equation is capital P is equal to IRMS square into R. So you have to keep this in mind. If you are resembling this formula with the third chapter or DC chapter, you have to remember in this chapter capital I and V means the RMS value of the voltage or a current. Now let us see example 7.1, where we have a AC circuit. So a light bulb is rated at 100 watt. So we have a power of a bulb to be 100 watt for 220 volt supply. So here 220 volt supply is given. So actually it is capital V, or we can write VRMS value. So it is connected with the 220 volt supply. So actually this 220 volt is fixed. RMS value is fixed. What we have to find out? The first thing you have to find out, find the resistance. Then find out the peak voltage, means VM. And third, find out IRMS or capital I. I can write there symbol IRMS. So later on, after a few lectures, we will be using this symbol capital V or capital I for IRMS. So we have to find out IRMS. So first thing, we have a power. Again, this power is an average power. So VRMS, that is 220 volt. So directly we can find out the resistance. So power formula, if you remember, it is V square upon R also. This implies R is equal to, so here this for AC circuit, this P means average power and this V means VRMS. So resistance is equal to V square upon P, that is 220 into 220 divided by power 100. So this 0,0 cancel, it comes out to be 484 ohms. That is 22 square. So that is the first part. Then second part, Vm. So Vm is root 2 times Vrms. So this is root 2 times that we did already did this root 2 multiply by 220. So the peak value comes out to be about 311 volt that you can directly find out. And the third portion is find out Irms. So if we have a power, so average power can be written as capital V into I, where this capital V and capital I resemble with the DC chapter, but actually here V and I means RMS value. So this implies I is equal to P upon V, that is 100 divided by 220. So you find out this value 0 point something, that is the IRMS value, that is 10 divided by 22. So whatever answer you get, that will be the IRMS value. So this is how the formula resemble with that of DC. The only difference is you have to remember here we have capital V, capital I, the RMS value, and capital P is an average power. So in the coming lecture, we will see an AC circuit containing only inductor or a capacitor. Have a nice day.